Hello, it's Jim from JetsonHacks.com. On today's show, we are going to install a solid-state disk on board the NVIDIA Jetson AGX Xavier Developer Kit. Let's get started. One of the nice things about the Xavier is that there is a M.2 Key M slot where you can install a solid-state disk. Make sure that you have a PCIe version of the M.2 Key M drive. Today we're going to install a Western Digital WD Black high performance NVMe SSD. It's 500 GBs. You know how we like our GBs. Today we're using the anti-static mat so we don't have any ESD issues. I'm going to wear my little wristband and put it on. I'll leave a link in the description below to this particular mat. It's a portable one. That's why it has these little ridges in it, because we fold it up. The M.2 Key M slot is located between the carrier board and the Jetson module. Let's turn our Xavier upside down here. To detach the Jetson module from the carrier board, we need to remove these four screws. 1, 2, 3, 4. We will use a number 2 Phillips screwdriver. There's a little bit of Loctite on the screws. It might take a little bit extra to get the screw undone. We'll put these aside. There is a 699-pin connector holding the module to the carrier board. It's located right here. So we will carefully disconnect it. We need to be careful when we detach it. There is a wire that goes from the module to the carrier board, which controls the fan. It's very delicate, so we want to be careful. Move this out of the way for the moment. The wire is not long enough to reach from the top of the Jetson module to the surface of the table. I'm going to use this hideously colored piece of foam to support the carrier board when I remove it. You could use a book or something. You may want to consider removing this connector. You'll need a pair of tweezers. But the wires are very tiny. I don't want to mess with it. Here's the M.2 Key M connector. Here's the 699-pin connector. And here's the mate for it. Let's remove this screw, which will hold the card in place. Let's take our SSD card out of the package. Oh boy, instructions. Some people might find these useful. Put the packaging aside. Let's put our SSD in. Then let's install the mounting screw. Put this back on. And let's put our standoffs back in. Installation complete. The next step is to hook up our Xavier and configure the disk. Let's switch over to our screencast. We're back over on our machine. Let's take a look at our disks application. Oh, look at this. 500 GBs, just like we predicted. Let's format the disk. Go up to the utility menu. Format disk. Compatible with modern systems. That's what we want, GPT. Format. Are you sure you want to format the disk? Yes, please, format. Password. Okay, now we have free space of 500 gigabytes. Let's add a partition. notice that the little plus button showed up. Our partition size, let's make it the full size of the disk. Next, we will give it a name, Xavier SSD 500. That sounds fast. We want to make sure that it's Linux ext4. Create. Okay, so now we have our device. P1, one partition. If we want to come back later and change our partition size, we can do that using the little gear icons. Resize it. The triangle here mounts our selected partition. Let's open her up. The folder is empty. And there's our little disk. It seems relatively happy. We may also want the disk to auto mount when we boot the system. Let's go back to our disks app. Edit the mount options. Here are all our options. You may want to change the mounting point or whatever to match your particular preferences. For the purposes of this demonstration, we'll just leave it like this. Okay. Okay, we're going to add an entry to the etc fstab file. Authenticate. Let's reboot. Okay, let's take a look. Other locations. And here it is, Xavier SSD 500. You can see that it is mounted. If you like this video, give it a thumbs up. Please subscribe if you are not already. Thanks for watching.